Hello and good evening.
Yes, good evening.
Welcome to English coaching class. Students, in our coming classes, we'll be discussing some chapter, some topic related to class 12 from textbook Flamingo. Before going for the discussion of our today's topic, just I want to tell you in our last class what all we have discussed. We have completed the chapter Deep Water. We have completed the chapter Deep Water by William Douglas. I have taken the chapter into 3 to 4 parts. 3 to 4 parts is in a line-wise explanation of the chapter. And in the very first beginning, I have taken 2 videos on introduction. Part 1 and part 2 of introduction. And 4 parts of video I have shared where I am giving the line-wise explanation of the chapter. And here today, I will be sharing you the information, or we can say recapitulation of the chapter Deep Water, where I'll be recapitulating the chapter or recap of the chapter Deep Water. Okay, today's topic. I hope so, students, you are able to understand. Today's topic is Deep Water, and we'll be recapitulating, means I'll be recapitulating, recap, flashback, where in the things, whatever I've talked to you, I've shared you from the Deep Water chapter, and all the videos link will be shared, and students, you can click and see all the videos that I have done, I've completed in the chapter Deep Water. Okay, and I'll be sharing you that screen where I'm going to begin with the discussion today. Okay, students, so just have patience and just try to give little bit think some what we have discussed in our last class, and I'll be covering the same recap of the chapter, and we'll discuss question answers. Okay, so let's see that page. Yeah, so I'm with that page, students. I hope everything is visible. So it's just a recap. I told you, students, it's a recap, a recapitulation of what we have discussed in our last class. So that I'm going to discuss today, and where I'll try to give you the recap where you can recall all the informations what we have done it. So students, Deep Water by William Douglas. So it is an autobiographical. I have made it clear in all the classes what I have taken, that autobiographical and biographical concept. So this is an autobiographical written by William Douglas. So it's about his life. About his life, he is a protagonist. He is a protagonist. He's a protagonist means hero. He's a hero. He's a protagonist of the text Deep Water. I hope students are clear about it. So just theme of the chapter. In this essay, William Douglas talks about his fear of water. See, students, in my introduction classes, I've discussed on the fear, what are the fear, what is fear is known as phobia, and in which situation, how we are facing the phobia, how phobia develops in individual. I have talked in the introduction classes. I have shared the message, I have shared the ideas, I have shared the introductory idea of the chapter. Now, it's a conclusion where I'll be summarizing all the events, whatever I have shared in introduction, in a line-wise explanation. So here, seeing the fear of water. So Douglas is talking the whole chapter, that is about fear of water. How he finally overcomes it by his courage. Mark it down, students. I'm just underlining those points here. And just even you can take a snapshot, or you can write whatever copies I have asked you to make it. So you can write it down in a relevant copy. Okay. So how he finally overcomes it by his courage, first, determination, second, hard work, third, and fourth, strong willpower, and 5, perseverance, and 6, desire to learn. Okay. And here the 5 to 6 points that I have discussed in your last class. Okay, so here in the present time, I'm trying to recall the same. What are the 4 points? What are things connecting to the theme? Courage, one should be courageous. See, students, you might be facing the situation where you in the exam tense and exam pressure. The students, when they commit, for example, when you start solving the mathematics, when you face problem, you cannot continue because you start thinking that I cannot do it. I need a guidance. I need a teacher. I need a tutor. I need my friend. I need someone who can help me to overcome this problem. So similarly, what is that courage? You have to be courageous to share with someone. If you'll share, the other one can take care of yours in that particular problem. If you can't share, you don't have that courage to share, there's your problem won't be solved. So that's your first and foremost, the point is courageous. Second, you must be determined. You must be set up your mind to work on that particular problem. You're not determined. You cannot solve that problem. The fear of water, fear of examination, it's examophobia, fear of water, hydrophobia, whatever phobia you might be having. Okay, so it is hard work, and students these days they are doing smart work. So when you are having a problem, some subjects, some situations, definitely you need to work on it. And next coming, it's your strong willpower. That's major point here. That's a major point. Strong willpower. Someone is not having strong willpower, then he cannot be determined even, and his hard work will go in vain. One will work for a day, 2 day, 3 day, and 4 day. Come on, today I'm tired. I won't go. Strong willpower is not there. His time a fish. He cannot work. Perseverance. You have to pursue. Okay, you have to work on it for the longer days. So you have to have a patience to work on it for the longer days and need the continuity. Okay, so that perseverance, have to continue some work for long days. That perseverance should be there in you. And desire to learn. Remember the students, when you don't have desire to learn, you cannot learn anything. Anything, whoever is teaching to you, even the God will come in front of and sit in to you. If you don't have desire to learn, you cannot learn it never. Okay. So similarly, learning, it may be from a teacher, it may be from a friend, it may be from a parent. Anyone can be here to who can impart you the process of learning. Okay. But you should have a desire. So you got it. The idea is clear. This is about the theme, what we have been discussing in the introductory chapters. And this is about the theme. If these are the practiced, we can definitely achieve success in all our endeavors, in all our problems. This is the basic concept. This is the basic solution we can overcome. Got it, students? Come to the gist of the lesson. Okay, or summarizing informations. The point number one, William Douglas had a desire to learn swimming since childhood. Mark it down. It's saying that from since childhood, you remember students, at the very early age, next point, at the age of 3 or 4, he was knocked down, buried by a wave at the beach in California. Remember, just I'm citing one example. See, you're playing with your friends and you fall down. Okay. And what happened? Friends around you, instead of helping you to get up and let's play back. But what happened? They started laughing. You feel ashamed because you're in a public place. And they're making laugh at you. What you did it, you fell down. And due to this, they're laughing at you. So that kind of thing, when you're ashamed of something, and that kind, when you do next time that kind of thing, you are very cautious. Similarly, this boy is at the age of 3 and 4. And he cannot be cautious. The situation happens one strike to the brain, and it's difficult to overcome. So this is the incident when the fear of water initiated us, get a start in his brain. This is the age, that is 3 or 4 when the incident happened with him at the beach in California. Clear, students? If understood these lines, what I have explained, come on, write it down in the chat box. I can see, yes, you are active, you are listening to me. Okay, so just write it down, students. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, students, you are answering, that's good. Yeah, that's good. He developed a great aversion to the water. Yes, that's good. So what happened? He got an aversion. When we like something, we go for it. When we don't like something, we don't go for it. So the negativity, negative side, no positive side, no liking has been developed. Means he is not liking the water from that day onwards. So dislike started. He developed a great aversion to the water. He did not like the going to the water. Understood? Next, at the age of 10 or 11, he decided to learn to swim with water wings. Water wings, you might have seen it, when the kids, when they go in the foreign, they have a different kind of wings. And when you'll go in a local area, what we can say, lake or something, you'll be seeing the wheel will be there. Chaka, what we talk about in Odia. Okay. And they go for enjoying in a river or in a pond or lake. But in the America or in the foreign countries, they have a different what wings and all in a very different style. Okay. We are the common people. Here the people are using the different things. Okay. So here, what we can say, at the age of 10 or 11, decided to learn to swim. Again, set of mind, desire to learn. Okay. So the desire initiated in his part. Okay. So he what happened? He was very much interested to learn again at the age of 10 or 11. So the very initial lines talking about the since childhood, he was interested to learn swimming. The same again, the water aversion developed, but see, determination, willpower. Yeah, I will learn. How will you do it today or tomorrow? I'll be a successful man. Success doesn't have exact definition. What is success defined? Someone want to be happy without doing anything. That is a success for me. And then happiness matter. So the similar way. So at he is coming up again back, challenging himself back. To learn to swim. Okay, students? With water wings at the YMCA pool. With water wings. Okay, at YMCA pool. And since it was safe at the swallow end. Just mark it down. It was safe in a swallow end. Underlining, I'm underlining the word and you will mark it down. At the age, what was the situation there? Depth. Means see, you might have seen the swimming pool. You might have seen it. It's built when it is there for familiar use or when someone will be training in the beginning days. Initial learning is imparted. So what happens? It is like a stairs from everywhere. When you're standing in a stair, stair is in a what sliding way. It moves down. Okay, when you stand on top, you'll be standing. When you keep another step, you'll move down. Another step, move down. So when you move down and find a last step, it's a height, a good height is developed. So similarly, the middle of the word pool is swallowed deep. When you're standing the side, it's in a proper height. But when you're coming down and down, it's getting a dangerous alarming. When you know how to swim, it is easy for you. You can even stand in the middle. If you don't know, you cannot stand in the middle because it is a you are in a learning state. So it is saying it was safe at the swallow end. Okay, in the swallow end it was safe, but when it goes down, it is not safe. It becomes a 9 feet. Our height is 5.5, 5'10", 6. It's 9 feet. It is covering your head. Okay. So what happened? A misadventure took place while sitting alone and waiting. So this was the he decided to move for what? Swimming at YMCA. Pool. Okay, it is in Yakima, America, the place known as Yakima. And there's an incident, there's a reason when it was named, what was the name, and related to a man known as Yakama. And with his name, this place was named. Okay, so Yakima, in place Yakima, and in that there's a Yakima river, even in the same place. So, in that same place, he went to the YMCA pool. YMCA students, I hope you remember the last class, in a very introductory class, I have shared the YMCA full form. Even it is present in India also, YMCA different places, it's also present in India. There's some answer, I think, so yeah, one student is replying, he remembered it. YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association. I'm repeating it, students, Young Men Christian Association. It's there everywhere, and even in India also. YMCA, and they have their gatherings, Christian Association Young Men's, they have their gathering, and they do social service work everywhere. Young Men Christian Association. Yeah, Christian, yeah. So, a misadventure while sitting alone and waiting. See, once you have a fear, for example, you have a fear of height, you have a fear of riding bicycle. When you first day again, you set your mind, no, I'll try again and I'll ride bike or a bicycle. I'll go to height and I'll jump. So when you try for something, you see people, how they are doing it. You learn from others, then only you can come up and do it. You see how the other one is riding. You see how your friend is doing. Most of the 90% time, you might have seen your parents might be giving the example that, see, that friend, he or your brother who has scored in IIT this much or in board exam this much or for medical and need this much. So you see that people cite example for others. When you see others become example for you. Similarly, this is the same situation when you become example. Okay, the same situation when you the people give example to you. Okay, and when by these examples keep you inspiring. Okay, these examples keep you inspiring and you get inspiration. And slow and steadily, you are able to overcome your problem. Similarly, it happened the same when this boy came to the YMCA pool. Okay, he's coming to the YMCA pool. He did not start swimming. He did not learn swimming on the very day. He started observing people, how people are doing their activities, how the people are in swimming there, how the swimming is done there. He's looking to the people and he's trying to learn from them. Okay, as people give you example, your parents give you example, your teachers give you example, your seniors are the example for you. Similarly, he's learning from others. See, that matters a lot. How you're surrounding, how you're learning from the surrounding. Similarly, this is happening with him. And what happened next? See, at the YMCA, he's able to try to adjust with his mind, brain, physically. Yeah, I can try, I can do it. Same time, a misadventure took place at the YMCA pool. A big boy came and threw Douglas into deep end of the pool. Big boy. A big boy refers in the text like a bruiser. A bruiser means a heavy, muscular body like a boy. And you hold him like from the back only, as in the same sitting position. And the choke slam, you might have seen students WWE or WWF. They use the choke slam, the how to heat it down, holding the neck and just put it down in the table. You might have seen it. In similar way, the boy lifted him and threw him into the water. And same way, he went to the down to the pool. Okay? I hope students, you are able to understand what I have explained till here. I hope students, yeah, come on. If you're active, come on, write it down. Yes, I can see. There's some replying. Yeah, come on, all. If you're active, come on. This is a virtual class and I must see all must be active. Okay, next one. I hope students, you are able to understand. Next line I'm coming up. Douglas swallowed water and went straight down to the bottom of the pool. Okay, Douglas, see that you don't know swimming and you have a fear of water. When you go down, what happens immediately? The fear of water comes to your mind, strikes you back, and suddenly you're not ease in that state. Okay, so Douglas swallowed water immediately when he went down. He drank water and went straight down to the bottom of it. As there was full force, full power he has used, right? The boy went down to the immediate bottom of the pool. While going down, he planned to make a big jump upwards, but came up slowly. You know, students, you are science students, and mostly even commerce students are watching. They have read it science in junior classes. See, when the human body moves under to the water, automatically our weight increases. We feel that heavy, and when we are not able to move our body easily. Okay, so as the body that this boy, when he's moving down, is going down straight. Okay, William Douglas swallowed water and went straight down to the bottom of the pool. When he's going bottom of the pool, while going down, he planned to make a big jump. Okay, you might have seen the cork, bottle cork, when he threw to the water, what happened? It does not move down immediately. He's just like he's jumping like waves on the surface of the water, up and down, and he's there. I mean, the bottle cork remain on the surface of the water. But exactly the planning is coming in the mind of the boy. Same way. While going down, he planned to make a big jump, okay, upwards, but came up slowly. He planned to make a jump like a cork. Immediately will go down, immediately will come up. So he planned to do the same, but he was not in success. He was not success. He did not get success. Okay, he was not successful, but came up slowly. He came up slowly. Stark terror seized him. Means the terror that was there in his mind seized him. He was not able to come up. When the fear that was existing in him, it developed, that level of terror increased. Okay, and seized him. He was not able to do his activity as he planned it. Tried to shout but could not. See, the water, you know, the science, again, the science is working here. The voice does not, he is not able to transfer or move as it is fast in air. The sound is not able to transfer as it is able to transfer in the sound. And when we'll shout inside the water, it won't be easily audible to others, those are outside the water. But when you'll shout in the normal surrounding in air, it will be audible to the far distance. So similarly, it is not easy, it was not audible to others. It was not easy, as if he was shouting and he was listening. He was only listening. As he went down the pool second time, when he tried it, he came up. First time he came up, and what happened? Only nose and mouth was out. Eye was inside. He tried to come up. He tried to raise his hand to gather something that he can hold and come up, but no one was there to help him. No one was there. Just what happened? He is trying to see the only water all around, and tried to take the deep breath. What happened? Only water went inside the mouth. Water went inside the mouth, and instead of breath, so he went down again. And as he went down the pool second time, means inside the pool, he tried second time. He's going down, and he's planning to come up again on the surface of the water. He tried to jump upwards, but it was a waste of energy. Tried it second time, but he did not get success. He did not get success. It was also failure. It was went in vain. Terror held him deeper and deeper. See, a swimming pool, it's not a river. It's not a sea. It's not an ocean. And you will die. That due to terror, see, you might have heard the student, I'm saying it, repeating that proverb again. You have heard it in the Julius Caesar, that quod is die thousand death, but what brave ones. So if you'll be a coward, and if you won't come up, and with that fear, you will die daily. You cannot survive, you cannot withstand, and you cannot live your life. Okay, so what happened? Terror held him deeper and deeper. During the third trial, he sucked water instead of water. So first trial, he went down, little bit of water went. Second time he tried, again went down. And third time, totally proper, sufficient water he took it. And due to taking a sufficient water, he was feeling choked inside the body, inside the stomach, in kidney, he was feeling like a choke. Light was going out and there was no panic. There was no more panic. There was no terror. There was no much fear. And he was accepting that he is going to die. As if you are in your mother's arm, as safe you are. Similarly, he is feeling that safe when he's going to sleep, permanent sleep. And the sleep has been used in the text. So here, sleep refers to the permanent sleep, where he is accepting he cannot fight with his journey. He cannot fight with his life for the survival. He cannot fight with the process, the coming and up. So as he's a fear of water is already there in his brain. Okay, so he ceased all efforts and became unconscious. So what happened? He did not die. Remember, student? So in that he felt it is dying, but he did not die. He crossed to oblivion. He crossed to oblivion. He crossed that stage of death, but he did not die. Okay. So what happened next? Let's see. When he revived, he found himself vomiting. Okay. When he revived, he found himself vomiting. You might have seen in movies when he would take the heroine out from the river or from sea or some other state of water when the heroine is there or some other one the members are there, they bring it out, they press the stomach to bring down the water from the mouth. Okay, a similar way, this boy was lying with the pressure of stomach. Stomach was there, he was down to the earth. The stomach was there, he was lying down. Means he was not there in a straight and he was turned down. Okay, and there was a pressure that due to the pressure of the lying down, the water can come out from his mouth and he can feel better. So the same was done here. We revived, and when revived, he found himself vomiting beside the pool. So the vomiting was there to bring out the water. Okay, not vomiting exactly, that really what happens. The vomiting was to bring out the water, what he is taking instead of a lack of air. Okay. I hope, students, you are able to understand. I'm not going fast with you. I hope you are able to understand. Okay. If any issue, write it down personally in my chat and definitely I'll help you out if there is any problem anywhere. He was in grip of fear of water. He was in a grip, means the fear of water has hold him properly. He was in a grip. When you hold your back, the grip of back is within your hand. Similarly, he was, the fear of water has totally captured him and he was totally surrounded with the fear of water. It deprived him of the joy of canoeing, boating, swimming, and fishing. He likes canoeing, boating, swimming, and fishing. These are activities that is done in water. Okay, boating, swimming, canoeing, fishing, these are all activities, and he was deprived of, means he did not enjoy. Whenever he was going to these places, the same fear of water will return to him and he cannot enjoy. Understood, students? So this was his problem. And so I told you, set of mind is must. You must be, have a willpower. So the again, what happened? The willpower was there with this boy. The boy was determined. Boy was having willpower. Boy has a set of mind. Yes, I will learn. I will overcome my problem. So see, students, he is doing the same. What happened? What he is doing? The instructor, he hired an instructor to learn swimming. See, students, whenever in your life, whenever it is a practical example also, whenever you have a problem in your life, you need a guide. You need a guide, you need a teacher, you need a teacher, you need a guide to whom you can talk, you can share your problems, and he can help you out to bring out from that problem. It might be anyone, any teacher it can be. It can be a friend, can be a teacher, friend can be a guide, father, mother can be a guide, anyone. So you must need a guide or instructor in your practical life situation. Similarly, this boy hired an instructor to learn swimming. So he taught him how to do swimming. Okay, how he can swim. So he got an instructor who taught him. Okay, I hope students are able to understand till here. The next line, the instructor taught him swimming piece by piece. Okay, piece by piece. You are taking a bite one by one, piece by piece. And this is not that. The piece refers here, one by one, he taught all the steps. Okay, when you go, if you have ever, I'll share my experience when I was a student in my school days. Okay, in my school days experience I'm sharing when I was a student. And this is talk about the school days. I started going, during summer vacation, I started going to an academy where I can play basketball. Okay, so I was short-heighted in that time and my instructor did not allow me to play on the very day. For a few weeks, about two weeks, he gave me just a ball, hold it and do just run 2 to 3 rounds of that big field and go for a dribbling with the ball. Hold the ball and have a control on the ball. And when you have a control, I learned it, I understood later on. When I'll have a control on the ball, when I'll be playing with my friends, and he made me understand this is the way you can take it, you can do it. He taught me all these ways. Then only when I played match, I was able to shoot or do the basket properly. Similarly here, students, the piece by piece refers to thing. All tricks, techniques of swimming was taught one by one. Okay, it is not a food item or something in a piece he has taken. It's one by one, he taught him all the steps, or he instructed all the things, whatever need to burn. One by one he did it. He did not taught him in one day. What is it? Okay, students, next line. He went to different lakes to swim. So after that, see, you remember the Sultan? I'll just give the example of Sultan, movie Sultan, made by Salman Khan. Okay, so in that one, there was a, in the last part, Sultan ko sirf Sultan hi hara sakta hai. Okay, and in this part, there's a quotation in my introduction class, I have shared it. That is from President Roosevelt, shared the quote. And the same quote is I have shared even in my introduction class. The quotation was that Roosevelt quote, if students you remember, you can write it down in the chat box. I hope if you feel right, repeatedly said, just take a speak, write it down and remember. If you remember, just tell me. Okay, so the same, it's similar to the Sultan's quotation. Okay, Sultan says, Sultani hara sakta, means the fear in us, who can defeat? I, the individual, you, means if you have fear, with having fear in you, you are only able to defeat. No one else can overcome your fear. You have to challenge yourself. Today, see, the improvement in you, challenge in you, is that what you are today, what you'll be tomorrow. Not you're going to compare what I am in this stage, my friend is in this. You cannot compare with anyone. You compare yourself, what you are today, what you can be in future. So that's your big challenge that you have to take in your life. So similarly, this boy did the same. This boy did the same. After learning, when the instructor certified him, okay, you can learn, means you can train. At the same time, he, what happened? He went to different lakes to swim. So after that, he challenged himself. He went to different lakes to swim and found teeny vestiges. And the fear is returning back. Again, that flashback is coming. The fear of water is coming. Still grieved him. He's trying to capture. And this man challenged, hey, fear of water. Hey, fear. Come on, get lost. I'll take a one more ride. He started swimming from this direction to another direction in lake, in river. He started doing it and he challenged himself. So challenge is, you challenge yourself. Today I have scored in my examination 20 marks out of 40. Tomorrow I'll score 25. Tomorrow I'll score 30. And by the next day, when the time will come, you can score 40 out of 40. But you have to challenge yourself. So you will challenge and you'll get the result. So that is the same thing he is doing. You have to be determined, you have to wield power, and you have to challenge yourself. Next point. swimming up and down the warm lake, he finally overcome his fear of water. So when in the swimming up and down, moving here and there, continuously in the warm lake, the river lake name is here, name is the warm lake, and underlining the name, finally when he finally he got that, I have overcome my fear of water. So he, that was in the warm lake. Remember the student. He realized that in death there is peace. There is and there is still only in the fear of death. So underline, he realized, what did the realizes matter? If you do some mistake, when you realize it, you have really overcome. You have really overcome that. You won't be doing that mistake again. So realization matter. Someone is doing some mistake. You must realize. You must accept. You have done that mistake. Okay, so he realized in death there is peace and there is terror only in fear of death. And fear of death, if you dar kab tak jiyega, dar mat, so don't have fear, don't be coward, what I said in the Julius Caesar part. Okay, coward is die 1,000 death but brave once. So same way, the same context, same quote of Julius Caesar is applicable is here. Will to live is stronger than fear of death. Will to live, I will survive, I will fight for my life, I am there, I have a confidence. Yes, students, this is a sum up idea about the chapter William Douglas. Okay, written by William Douglas, that is Deep Water. I hope I'm able to touch all the points required for chapter understanding of chapter, that is summarizingly I have covered it, because in the introduction class I have taken 2 videos and in the line wise explanation I have taken 4 videos and the single video that you can understand. Students, they prefer shortcut, so long cut, shortcut, everything I am giving to your students, you can see and enjoy and understand. If you have any issues, you can tell me. So now students, we will be going for the next segment for question answers. If you have any issues for the understanding, you can write it down. I will explain you. And now we'll go for a discussion of question answers. Yeah, there's a question here. Why was Yakima Pool considered safe when compared to the Yakima River? Here, the answer I have shared you, you may take it down. Yakima River was very deep, precarious. There were many cases of drowning. But YMCA pool, only 2 or 3 feet. Okay, YMCA pool only 2 or 3 feet deep at the swallow end. In the swallow end, it was 2 to 3 feet. And stairs, like in the middle portion, there's a swallow end. So in that one, it is 2 to 3 feet deep. Okay, at the swallow end. Why? It was 9 feet at the deep. In the 9 feet, it was total 9 feet deep, but only in the swallow end, it was 3 to 4 feet. Okay. So YMCA pool was considered safer when compared to Yakima River. In compared to Yakima River, YMCA pool was safer. Okay, students, I hope you are able to understand the answer. Next question. Why did his aversion to water begin? Why did the aversion of water begin? His aversion to water began when he was 3 or 4 years old, when his father took him to California beach. Remember it. In this particular, say only this instant, no other instance you'll be connecting it. This is the instance where the fear of water started. Okay. There, the waves knocked him down and swept over him. This is the incident and where the fear of water entered in his mind. Okay. Got it? Understood, students? Next question. What was the misadventure that happened one day? Yeah, I have explained to you the big bruiser boy picked him and tossed him into the 9 feet deep end of the YMCA pool. He hit the water surface in a sitting position. He swallowed water and went at once to the bottom. He nearly died in the misadventure. So this is a short question, very direct and very short. This all the informations are provided. So when it is a long answer, you are going to describe all the three situations. First, when he went down, how did he feel when he come out? Second situation, he was again pulled down. Third situation, all the situation you are going to describe when it is a long answer. But it is a short answer, this all informations are sufficient. Okay, so next one, what strategy did he remember as he went down to the water? Strategy, what was the strategy? To hit the bottom. And say, students, I have just given the points. But when you'll be writing the answer, full detail answer. To hit the bottom and spring or jump upward. When he'll go down, he'll like a spring, he'll jump upward. Bob to the surface means he'll come to the surface of the water like a cork. Means like cork, he'll go up and down and come out of the water. Okay, so this was the plan, he made it. This was strategy, he made it. This was the plan, he was there in the mind of William Douglas. Okay, what effect did the drowning in the YMCA pool have on the Douglas? What was the effect? Okay, so there's a whatever even happens, there's a positive and negative effect. So this is the what is the effect did the drowning in the YMCA pool have on the Douglas? Yes, students, weak and trembling. He was weak after that. He was not, was shaking, haunting fear returned him, deprived of joy of canoeing, boating, and swimming. This was the means what after the situation, afterward moving down, after effect. What was the after effect? They say he was weak and trembling. He was always, whenever he used to go to the bed, the same fear was returning back, the same haunting fear was there. So this was the after effect when he drowned in a YMCA pool. Got it clear? So next one, what method did he adapt to overcome terror? What was the method? A rigorous training. Okay. A rigorous training, breathing, moving of the legs, etc. So he started walking. Teacher or trainer was appointed. Guide was there who can show him the path, which path he will go. The teacher certified, but you have to challenge. Teacher will say you can do this, but you have to prove whether you are able to do it or not. Means how you prove? By practicing, by writing. See, I am discussing the questions and answer both. But the thing is not over. I'll give the questions. You have to practice and give me the answer writing in WhatsApp. So I will look at what you have done it, whether it is correct or not. I'll verify and I'll tell you, students, yeah, it is correct. Then you can improve yourself. So that always needed both the side work. So students, you have to look into the question and answer and questions I'll be sharing. These are the few sample questions for the discussion. Next question, the long question. Okay. How did the misadventure in YMC pool affect Douglas? How did the misadventure? What was the mis? And how did he overcome? See, the two short questions, what we have discussed, that has been taken jointly presented for the long question. So if you're able to solve the short question easily, you can elaborate your idea, you can add your vocabulary, you can add your informations, and that will become a long questions. Okay, so practice makes a man perfect. So when you are going to practice, you can be a perfect one. And when you are perfect, you can improve more and more, and you have to more and more. So then I'll say perfect practice will make you a perfect man. So then you can go for perfect practice. So first you practice and make yourself perfect. Then you go for perfect practice. Okay, students? So these are the lines here. Worst 10 or 11 decided to learn. These are the points what we have discussed. So you can look into it. You can take a snapshot. When I'll give questions to write it down, you can write. Here are some short questions. Okay. Definitely take a snapshot of this. Okay, student, definitely take a snapshot of these questions. Write it down and share to me. Okay, write it down and share to me. And definitely I'll answer you back how you have written. What is the level of writing? How your writing is? Definitely I'll look into it. And what to be improved, I'll share you the message in the WhatsApp again. Okay, thank you, students. Yes, students, just take a snapshot of this question, short questions, six questions I am sharing it here. Take a snapshot and definitely it will help you overcome your problem. Definitely it will help you when you write and show me the answer. Okay, and see here the few long questions, a value-based question, even the text-based question, and here normal situation based question. Here the long questions you will be getting. This long question carries of 6 mark, and that short question carries of 2 marks as per present question pattern. Previously short questions were 3 marks, these days it's coming of 2 marks as per the marks you're going to write the answers. When it is of 3 marks, you write of 3 marks. When it is asked for 2 marks, you'll be writing for 2 marks. Okay, students. So here are the few questions. Take snapshot and definitely come back to me. Show me the answers and definitely I'll help you out. I am assuring you, I'll be replying you back and I'll be coming in touch with you, students. This is my promise. And just you make me promise that definitely you will be coming. I'll writing the answers and showing you back. Okay, students, take the snapshot and just have patience. Just have a patience for the next video where I'll be coming up for the new chapter. Okay, new chapter, introduction, class, new concept in different style. Okay, if you're a new user, definitely subscribe my channel and just press bell icon. When I upload my video, definitely you can enjoy my class. Definitely you can enjoy my class. This is for today's students. And don't forget to take the snapshot. Don't forget to take the snapshot of the questions. Okay, so definitely I'll be coming in touch with you. And definitely I'll be coming in touch with you and I'll be sharing all the informations, whatever will be helpful for your guidance. Thank you, students. Best of luck. And I'm waiting for your message and with the answers. Okay, thank you. Sign out. Bye-bye. Good night. Take care. Okay, students. Bye. Thank you.